Last year, 43% of the entire finish of the field finished in the last hour. It is a massive percentage. So right now, close to half the finishers are still out there.
Yeah, in terms of club runners, these are perhaps the elite of the average club runner. And because they're finishing under 11 hours. As you say, the other half, they finish after the 11-hour cutoff. What's also quite significant is these days, with the larger fields, it takes perhaps 6, 7, 8 minutes to cross that start line. And we saw that from the helicopter this morning. It took a long time for those runners to cross. And it does cost these guys a few minutes.
2 minutes to go, just over 2 minutes to go. And, of course, for the extra 800 meters or so, for these runners at these speed, Lindsay, that's 5, 6 minutes.
Yeah, that's 6.5 minutes. So these guys effectively had to find 6.5 minutes somewhere along the route. And as Alec pointed out today, the uprun normally clears in 6 minutes, but I think there were a lot more this year's uprun, so it took this group of people took 8 minutes to get across the line. So they found themselves 15 minutes, and that's actually quite an achievement. I hope that their loved ones recorded this, because they'll all be chuffed that Alec referred to them as elite athletes.
I'm sure they will. And but you know, these guys, they all train regularly. You know, when we talk about the Carolines and the gifts and things, I mean, those are, like, I mean, I know Caroline's not a professional, but those are the really elite athletes. I'm talking about elite average club runners. And here are these people, they train hard for an event like this. In the next hour, you'll see some people who've done it, you know, on perhaps just a run here and a run there. But these people have trained hard. You can see they're still running fairly strongly at this late stage of the day, and they've been on their feet for just short of 11 hours.
Well, 1 minute to go, and we know that it's not a long run around this track, but if you're not on the track right now, you've got a bit of a problem. And the gun goes off in just 48, 47 seconds from now. So there's a lot of speed on the track now. The guys know they've got their digital clocks. The people are screaming, and the public announcers will know. They start counting down. And it's desperate for them. That's very, very, very close. And they all want that bronze medal. And there's going to be some serious sprinting happening.
Look, it's always amazing to me. Look at these guys. Alex said, this is your average club runner, but look at how they are able to lift themselves. When the human wants to do something, it's incredible what they can pick up. But really, if they're not in the last 50 meters now, I think they're really struggling.
You know, I was down on the finish line for the Bull Run 9 hours, and the countdown starts, and you'll hear it in the background. Absolutely wonderful atmosphere down there. Yeah.
Well, there they go, and it's 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Off it goes, and that's it. The guy from with the orange vest there, we'll see who he was. Might have been one of the Team Vitality guys. And then all of a sudden, nobody's going fast behind them.
Now they're walking. These guys will be a little disappointed because they got so close to 11, but they will get back to their club tent. They'll be congratulated by people, and they will eventually realize that they have still achieved something amazing, and they will be very happy with themselves.
11 hours now that the race has been gone.
Yeah, and quite a few people just not being allowed to officially finish it, and it's quite disheartening, and they'll be thinking, oh, maybe if I hadn't stopped here, hadn't done this, done that. But the reality is, hopefully they'll go back, have a rest, start training, and not let the same thing happen next year.
No doubt. I think many people are coming here for the enjoyment, but at least they want to finish. At least they want to finish. It's a great disappointment for many of them not to be able to get through to the oval where we are to finish this race. And now the road has closed down for them as we take you down for the last time to Pauly's and Pauly Short.
That's it here at the Pauly Shorts. The cutoff has been done, and unfortunately no more runners are coming through. We did try to speak to some of the runners that didn't make it, but unfortunately they are really, really heartbroken. It has been a really long day. George, did you make cutoff?
No.
How are you feeling about that?
I feel a bit bad, but the thing is, I was helping my sister and my brother, and I didn't know that the cutoff is now.
I'm so sorry, George. But next year, at least you got here in time. Next year, we'll see you at the Comrades and you'll make it through, right?
Okay, I'll do that.
All the best, Nick.
Thanks.
Thank you, George. Oh, unfortunately, heartbreaking moments for some of the runners who didn't make it, but it's been great fun here at the 2015 Comrades Marathon. From myself, Mini Dlamini, it's at Mini Dlamini on Twitter, at sports at SABC, at Comrades Run, and hashtag 2015 Comrades. What? Just under an hour to go before the final cutoff. It's been absolutely awesome. Thank you so much for joining us. I'll see you this time next year, but we've still got more Comrades coming to you live after the break.
Less than 2 minutes to go before this cutoff.
Just looking out at the stadium here, there are still hundreds upon hundreds of people on this grass surface, this hallowed turf here in Pietermaritzburg, where these people are finishing a journey that may have started just 6 months ago, a journey that could have started 45 years ago, as in the case of an Alan Robb. And they're all looking for this medal. And I tell you what, you can see them egging each other on. It's absolutely fantastic. 1 minute and 15 seconds to go.
Also, the first minute, I'm taking it. From now, this guy will have to really make it a point that, oh my goodness, just look at this, Ian. Look at this, Arnold.
Amazing scenes here from the finish in Pietermaritzburg, and just more than 30 seconds to go now before we see two men, all women, of course, and it's going to be the happiest and the saddest person in here today. Well, I don't know if anybody's happier than the winners, but and 36 seconds, you're going to hear the crowd with a big countdown starting with 10 seconds to go, and I think we should just let them do that countdown and see where these athletes, they are straining across the line. 10 seconds to go now, and the big countdown is going to start. The mayor there standing ready with the gun. 5 seconds. And there it goes. The last man or woman is across the line, and the first person there has been stopped. They will not have officially finished the Comrade Marathon.
You know, the frightening thing is, Arno, that guy is going to wake up tomorrow, will sleep tonight with a nightmare thinking, why didn't I just stand 1 meter closer to the official start line? Why didn't I just move that one little bit faster at the start? Because that's what the difference was for that one poor guy. But these people, yeah, they're not getting a medal, but still, I believe, a sense of satisfaction of just finishing the distance.
That's what I said exactly, that each and every athlete here, you look at them, they have got the wristwatch, and that's wherein they need to really calculate their time to say anything can be able to come through today.
Well, we've got Lindani down at the finish line. He is going to speak to these athletes who either just made it or just didn't make it. And Lindani, down to you.
All right, sir, thank you very much. I think it really gets really emotional exactly when it hits that 12th hour mark. We've got a gentleman just here. He was the last guy who did not make it. You can just see the way he was so desperate to get in, but his legs just would not. Let me just see if we would be able to speak to him. Can we try and speak to him? Sir, how are you?
Oh, fine, thank you.
How was this race for you?
Oh, it was very, very tough.
Literally, I watched you. You were basically half a step away from making it to that 12th hour. How do you feel about this race?
Oh, I really enjoyed it, but I had this terrible cramp the last 5Ks, so I simply couldn't run anymore. I walked the last 5Ks and walked fast.
And obviously, because this race is all about those challenges, you've got another challenge now for next year to finish.
Oh, of course, I'll be back next year.
All right, so that was the runner that just didn't make it. But again, as I did say, this race is all about that courage and really pushing yourself. He pushed himself to that very last step, and hopefully next year he'll do much better. For now, though, it's back to you guys.